Welcome back sa page ko. I'm sorry, medyo natagalan yung ano ko class. Tawag dito yung rebut ko. Yung solution sa problem nito kasi napaka-busy ko. Grabe talaga guys, marami tayong pinagkakaabalahan ngayon. And but don't worry, hindi naman natin nakalimutan yung page natin. Especially ito, napagandang problem nito class. I really wanted to solve this for a long time para makita din ninyo, mayroong ibang nag-try, napakagaling yung mga nag-try. Okay? Tapos maganda yung answer nila, malapit na malapit, pero hindi natin alam kung tama ba kasi hindi sila nag-post ng solution. Pero tingnan natin ngayon kung tama ba yung mga solution ninyo. Okay? Napakagandang problem. Okay, basahin ko muna. A rocket combustion chamber, nandito, nasa page natin to, class, ito. Ito, nasa page natin yan, oh, di ba? Testing din yan ng ano natin, ng, tawag dito, yung bago nating tech na nandito. Kung okay ba to, pang video, para maging mas madali yung pag-solve ko ng mga problems, mas maintindihan ninyo. Tapos din, ngayon din ako nakakonect sa isang decenting internet provider na napakabilis na. Okay? Hindi na ako magsasabi kung anong internet provider kasi ayoko mag-promote. Oh, di ba? Okay. So, basahin natin. Sabi dito, a rocket combustion chamber, okay, is supplied with 20 pounds. Makikita natin yan. Okay? Wait. Okay. Ganyan. 20 pounds per second of hydrogen. Okay? So, ito yung fuel niya, class. Okay? Kasi, tawag dito, hydrogen eh. Diba? So, combustible yan. And, 80 pounds per second of oxygen. Oh, okay, ito pala yung fuel tsaka air niya. Well, in this case, hindi na siya air na yung may nitrogen. Okay? Because, most of air, okay? Most of the air, although hindi lang nitrogen tsaka oxygen yung nandyan, most of it is are comprised with what? Oxygen and nitrogen. Pero actually, what is needed for combustion is only oxygen. So, kaya dito siguro, ginawa nila, hindi na nila sinama yung nitrogen kasi wala naman yung mangyayari, di ba? As you remember, in your combustion equation, di ba? Kunwari, may fuel ka dyan na hydrocarbon, okay, CH4, tapos meron kang oxygen, tapos meron kang nitrogen, okay? Paglabas nyan, okay, meron kang carbon dioxide, meron kang water, meron kang onboard oxygen, okay? Tapos yung nitrogen, hindi yan mag-iba. The same pa rin yan because the nitrogen is not combustible, okay? Dadaan lang yan, it will not react. Only the oxygen will react to the fuel, okay? Now, kaya dito siguro, yung ginawa niya, ano na lang, guys, tawag dito, pure oxygen. Okay? Ito yung rocket science. Okay? Now, sabi dito, ilagay ko na lang siguro dito, class. The mass of the hydrogen is, ano nga yun, 20 pounds per second. Tapos yung mass ng oxygen, it's what? 80 pounds per second. Ako gusto ko ganito mga problem, gas dynamics, kasi para nabubuhay yung ano ko, yung dream, childhood dream na maging ano, 'di ba? Astronaut. Okay, kasi rocket science eh. Now, sabi dito, before entering the nozzle, okay? Before entering, all the oxygen is consumed, okay? Okay, noted, consumed daw before entering, and the pressure and the temperature are, okay, before entering to, are 20 atmospheres, so meaning 20 times the atmospheric pressure and 4,900 degree Fahrenheit respectively. Now, the specific heat ratio of the combustion products may be assumed constant at equal to 1.25, okay? Neglecting dissociation and friction, okay, mas maganda, mas madali na lang. Kasi kung may friction, may mga inefficiency, mas mahirapan tayo to calculate that. And then, sabi dito, calculate the required throat area of the rocket propulsor booster. Naku, napaka-trailing naman ito, no? Okay, sige. Ma-illustrate na nga natin konti. Guys, okay, so parang nakikita ko dito ganito eh. Okay, ito yung chamber. Tapos ito yung nozzle niya. Oh, gaganyan siya. Okay? Tapos dito yung throat ng nozzle niya. Okay? Tapos dito lalabas yung combustion products, ganun. Okay, now. Brake line na lang tayo diyan. Sir, ano yan eh? Hose. Eh. Wag na, imagine niyo na lang ano yan, rocket. Pero actually, sa rocket naman hindi ganitong nozzle. Yung sa rocket yung ginagamit yung mga converging diverging, 'di ba? Yung gaganyan muna, then yung makikita mo sa labas gaganyan na, tama? Okay, kaya actually pag high speed gases, guys, pag high speed gases yung pinag-usapan, it's counterintuitive kasi 'di ba makikita natin pag low speed gases o low speed liquid fluids, pag tataas yung area, tawag dito, pag lalaki yung area, babagal yung velocity. Pero in the case of gas flow, high speed gas flow, after it reaches the critical ano dito sa throat, critical condition, it will expand and it will still increase its velocity. Okay? Yan yung isang property ng imbis na babagal siya, diyan. Pag high speed gas flow, instead of decreasing velocity na dapat kasi tataas na yung area niya, 'di ba? Tataas na yung area niya diyan. Anong mangyayari? The velocity will continue to increase. And we like it to gain more momentum. Kaya yung mga rocket, 'di ba, makikita mo yung ibang rocket ganun. Teka lang ah. Parang asagwana ng mga drawing ko eh. Okay. Oh, na lalong sumagwa. Oh, 'di ba? Makikita mo yung mga rocket, 'di ba? May pag ganyan 'yan. Tapos wag ganyan, 'di ba? Gaganyan yung mga rocket, ganun. Okay, anyway, so much for that. Balik tayo sa problem. Okay, sabi dito, going in is mass ng hydrogen dito sa combustor, 'di ba? Going in mass ng hydrogen. Okay? Kasi susunugin muna diyan eh para mag-combust, tsaka mass ng oxygen. Bali ito yung magiging hydrogen will become the fuel, oxygen yung sa part ng air, and then it will combust here. After that, the combustion gases will enter the nozzle para mas para bumilis. Now, dito before entering dito, yung ano niya guys, yung pressure tsaka temperature dito, yung pressure dito, let's call that PO, the initial pressure, or you call that stagnation pressure if you may, kasi yun yung pressure at the start before siya ma-compress. It's 20 atmosphere. Okay? Now, also, the stagnation temperature here, bakit tinawag ko pa rin na stagnation temperature? Kasi ito yung source eh. When we talk about gas dynamics, yung yung temperature tsaka pressure pag start, okay? Dito, and then from combustion, pag start niya pagpasok sa isang nozzle, isang converging-diverging nozzle, it becomes your stagnation pressure and temperature. Now, the stagnation temperature is 4,900 degree Fahrenheit. Okay, sige nga. Now, ang kailangan natin, actually, meron pa, teka lang, ilagay ko na lahat ng given. Tapos dito pa, merong K. Yung K natin, yung gustong gamitin is 1.25 and we use that. Okay? Now, ito mag-compress to dito yung gases to the nozzle. Okay? And then, the velocity here will increase. Now, the question is, what is the throat area here? Ano bang area dito daw? Okay? How can we do that? Di ba? Napakagandang problema. Ito lang yung meron ka. Well, we know that just from simple engineering knowledge that Q is equal to area times velocity. Tama ba? Siyempre, ito yung pinakauna mong atake kasi ito alam mo eh. Diba? Q is equal to area. So, yung volume flow rate ng gas papuntang nozzle, okay, o papuntang throat ng nozzle, itong maliit na ano dito, yan. Okay, yan. Is equal to the area of the throat times the velocity of the gas in the throat. Okay. Okay, good. Established. Now, we know also that the mass, the volume flow rate is equal to density times the mass flow rate equals area times velocity. Okay, tama. Kasi alam naman natin yung tawag dito, yung unit ng density is kilogram per cubic meter. Now, ito naman, cubic, teka lang. Hindi dapat density, dapat ano, specific volume. Sorry. Yung Q pala is equal to, yan, mass flow rate times specific volume. Kasi pag tinignan mo, yung unit ng mass flow rate, maybe in metric, that's kilogram per second, times eto, ano to, cubic meter per kilogram, tama ba? If you multiply that, tingnan mo, yun. If you multiply that, you get cubic meter per second, or that's a Q, that's a volume flow rate. Diba? Okay, very good. Now that we have that, okay, you can see that to get the area, okay, I will rearrange the formula. You have to have what? The mass flow rate, the specific volume, and the velocity. Diba? Ito, magkaiba yan ha. Ito, specific volume yan. May ano yan? May tail. Okay? Yes. Okay, and the velocity of the gas at the throat. So, ito lang yung kailangan natin kunin. Okay? We need to get the mass flow rate. We need to get the specific volume, and then the velocity of the gas at the throat. Okay, e, di ba? Madaling-daling sabihin, pero ang hirap gawin, di ba? Siguro, una nating isolve, class, yung ano, mass flow rate. Kasi ito yung unang nakikita ko, kasi meron tayong ano eh, meron tayong mass ng hydrogen, meron tayong mass ng, ano, tawag dito, mass ng oxygen. Okay, by simple, ano, by simple mass balance, di ba? If you have the mass of hydrogen going to the combustor, you have the mass of the oxygen also going to the combustor, then the mass that's going out, napaka no-brainer naman yan, di ba? Let's call that the mass of the gases, okay? By mass balance, automatic MH2 or the mass of the hydrogen plus the mass of the oxygen, okay, equals the mass of the gas. Okay? So, yun. Napaka no-brainer, class. So, the mass of the gas is equal to, okay, that's 20 pounds per second. And then, plus the mass of the oxygen, it's 80 pounds per second. So, therefore, the mass of the gas is equal to what? 100 pounds per second. Eh, gusto ko tong i-analyze, or I want to answer this in metric. Okay? Kasi minsan nagugulan ako sa ano eh, sa English. So I will convert this into kilogram per second, okay? So I will have 1 kilogram divided by ano, 2.205 pounds, okay? So I will divide this, and what do I get? As the mass of the gas, okay? Tingnan natin. I will calculate that. Kung wala ako ng calculator, saglit. Okay? So, we have 100 divide 2.205. I will have 45.35. Okay? So, ito yung mass ng gas ko. Mass flow rate ng gas ko dun sa throat, sa nozzle. 45 kilogram per second. Okay, now. Okay. Mas maganda siguro gawin ko na tong ano. Ano, class, no? Itong 8 atmospheric tsaka Fahrenheit. Gawin ko na rin tong ano, metric, tama? Okay, dito ko lang kaya. Yung equivalent yan na metric ng 20 atmosphere. I-multiply mo lang ng 20 yung 101.325. Okay? You have 2026.25. Okay, 2026.25. Okay? And yung TO, gawin mong Celsius. Alam mo na 'yon, yung anong formula, 'di ba? Hindi na natin 'yan i-detail. You convert that. 49 minus 32 times 5 divide 9, you get what? 2704.44. Eto, KPA na pala ito, class. Okay? eto ano na to, degree Celsius. Okay, na-convert ko lang kasi gusto kong i-analyze siya in metric. Now, meron na tayong mass ng gas, mass flow rate, kilogram per second. Anong next na pwede natin gawin? Well, we can solve for the what? For the eto. Etong specific volume. Well, we know in thermodynamics that the specific volume of any gas, okay, assuming that it's an ideal gas, okay, is equal to, assuming that the combustion gases follows the ideal gas behavior, okay, so we have RT over P. Now, ano bang meron tayo? Wala tayong temperature saka pressure kasi we don't use this pressure and this temperature. Bakit, sir? Kasi iyang pressure saka temperature na to na nanggaling is the inlet pressure and the temperature or the stagnation pressure and the temperature. We don't want that. We don't want the actual pressure and temperature here at the throat. And let's call that maybe P and T. Okay? We want the pressure and temperature there at the throat. And okay, still wala pa, I will need to solve it, and also I will need to solve R, di ba? Kasi yung nangyari, I don't know what is the R of the gas that I have here, or yung ano ba yung gas constant ng nabuong combustion gases. Sir, is it possible to solve for it? Yes, I think so. If you're really good with combustion engineering, masosolve mo yan. Bakit? Kasi defined yung ano eh. Defined yung mga gas, yung fuel tsaka air na ginamit mo, yung hydrogen, tsaka yung oxygen. Can I use, ano sir, yung gas constant ng air diretso? Hindi. Because it's a different story. Kasi composition ng gas mo. Okay, so anong pwede kong gawin, sir? Well, first of all, you need to establish the combustion equation so that you can determine the gas constant. Dadaan pa pala ako sa combustion. Oo, yun tayo eh. Diba? Dapat, kaya nga sinasabi ko palagi, when you try to understand the concepts in mechanical engineering, you have to understand it holistically. Okay, kasi yan, interconnected yan eh. Okay, punta na tayo sa combustion engineering. So, makikita natin, okay, H2, that is the fuel, and then the acting air is oxygen. So, ano kaya ang reaction? After reacting with hydrogen and oxygen, ano kaya yung magiging ano nito, byproduct? Ha? Ano kaya? Ha? Yes, tubig. Umatik yan, di ba? Water vapor, meron yan, water vapor. Okay? Meron yung water vapor. Maybe at first, ito lang muna, assuming that all of the oxygen will go into the ano, the oxygen. Okay. So, sir, may onboard oxygen pa. Maybe we can have onboard oxygen, pero sa ngayon, ito lang muna. Okay, tingnan natin. Can we balance it off para makita natin? Okay, now, to balance it off first, anong pwede natin gawin? Meron tayong ano eh, meron tayong tawag dito, hydrogen, meron tayong oxygen, dalawang atom ng hydrogen, dalawang atom ng oxygen, dalawang atom dito ng hydrogen, isang atom ng oxygen. So, to balance it, pwedeng natin lagyan ng 2 moles doon sa harap ng hydrogen. Okay, balance. 2H2 plus O2. Then, eto. Ngayon, to balance the other side, meron ka ng ano dito, di ba? 2 moles ng hydrogen. So, lahat ng atoms mo will become 2 times 2, 4. So, para maging 4 din yung atoms mo dito, lagay ka ng 2 sa harap ng tubig, water vapor, and you get what? Okay, balance equation. Oh, balance na nga, kasi may 4 na hydrogen ka, 2 mole ng oxygen, okay, so you have 2 atoms, so the equation is balanced. Now if we analyze, okay? If we analyze here yung ano niya, yung molecular weight. Syempre yung molecular weight ng hydrogen is 1. Tama? So the total molecular weight of this expression is 2 times molecular weight of hydrogen 1 2. So we have 4, 'di ba? We have 4 kilogram. I'm sorry, sorry, sorry. For yes, okay. Let's kasi pwede yan kilogram per kmol. So let's just say that it's per kilogram. Okay, yung balance lang, okay? Just to give the idea of the comparison of the weights. Then dito meron kang ano? Meron kang 2 atoms of oxygen. 1 atom of oxygen has a molecular weight of 16. So we have 32 kilogram. Diba? Then dito, ito, dalawang oxygen, tapos dalawang hydrogen. So we have 4 plus 32. We have 36. Okay. Okay, balance 'yan, 'di ba? 36 kilogram. So bakit ginanito ko? Sir, bakit ginanin mo? Okay? Kasi what I'm trying to do is to get the ratio of the fuel to my air. Tama ba? O tingnan mo. To be able to burn 32 kilograms, I need 32 kilograms of oxygen. Okay? I need 4 kilograms of hydrogen only and then I'm all good. Tama? I'm all good. So makikita natin ano ba yung ratio ng air fuel ratio ko. So 32 over 4, ano ba yung air fuel ratio ko? 32 over 4, that is 8. Tama ba? Kilogram of kilogram of oxygen over kilogram of hydrogen. Tama? That is my air fuel ratio. Now, what happens next is if I have that air fuel ratio, yung kagandahan kasi if I have that air fuel ratio, I can actually see kung lahat ba ng hydrogen mauubos. Kasi yung sinabi ng problem dito, I'm just trying to check. Kasi sinabi ng problem dito, lahat ng oxygen daw is consumed. So if the only guarantee na sa problem na yung lahat ng oxygen consumed. So it means all the 80 pounds, ito, lahat ng 80 pounds na yan, lahat ng 80 pounds na yan will be consumed. So therefore, if we have 80 pounds per second of oxygen consumed, okay, actually, you can have kilograms or pounds, okay lang po. Kasi, i-pounds na lang natin kasi pounds yung nasa ano eh. Walang problema, okay? Cancel muna natin to, bakit nandito to. Okay. And then ito, dapat pounds yan eh. Pwedeng pounds. Ito, 32 pounds. Ito din pounds. Okay, ito din pounds yan. Okay. So now, if I have 80 pounds, okay, 80 pounds of oxygen lahat. So it means how many pounds of hydrogen do I need to be able to burn this? To burn this. So I divide it by 8, di ba? Kasi ito 80 pounds of oxygen to eh. So 8 pounds of oxygen per pound of hydrogen. So what do I get? Okay? What do I get? I have what? 10. 10 pounds of hydrogen. So therefore, yan yung kailangan ko lang. 10 pounds of hydrogen. Now, reflecting on... Okay, excited. Excited na excited yung slide. Well, anyway, balik tayo dito. Tingnan natin, okay. Actually, may mali tayo dito sa equation. Kasi, ito na yung actual na... Ano eh, mas balance. Kasi, may sinaksak na yung 20 na... hydrogen, 80 na oxygen, lahat na consume, nagkaroon ng 10 na hydrogen, 10 pounds na hydrogen na sobra. So, to be able to balance it, alam ko na para mag-equal ng 100 yung lalabas, so maybe 90 pounds were yung na-create na tubig. Okay, now, if we base on that mass, pwede natin ma-ano to, actually, ma-edit yung equation natin to the actual. Okay? Paano sir? Well, based tayo dito sa actual mass niya. Dito, yung actual mass ng hydrogen is 20 pounds. So, to be able to get 20 pounds, I need what? 10 moles. Tama? 10 moles ng hydrogen. Okay? Dapat magaling ka din sa chemistry dito. Okay, 10 moles ng hydrogen, oh, dalawang atom ng hydrogen. Yung hydrogen is 1, yung molecular weight is 1 pound per pound mole. So, meron kang 1 pound per pound mole. So, dalawang atoms, so 2 na. 10 time, tapos times 10 pound mole, you get 20 pounds. Okay. So, therefore, we have that. Now, ito, 80. How can I get that? Well, I know that ito, ano to eh, di ba? Yung oxygen, 16. So, dalawang atom, 16 times 2, 32. Now, to get how many moles, so I will divide 80 by the molecular weight nito, yung oxygen gas. So, that's 80 divided by 32, 2.5. So, yung moles ko dito is, re-rate ko lang ha. Erase ko lang to, class. So, yung moles ko dito is, actually, 2.5. See? Okay? Now, eto, sa oxygen, ano ba yung moles ko dyan? Dito ko lang ilagay yan. Okay? I have 90 pounds. Ano ba yung total na molecular weight ng oxygen? Ng tubig. Dalawang hydrogen. So, 2. Tapos isang tubig, 18. Eh, may 90 ka. So, I will have 90 divided by 18. I will have 5. So, yung mole ko dito is... Oop. Yung mole ko dyan is 5. Then, the number of moles for the hydrogen is meron kang 10. Tapos, dalawa yung atom mo. So, yung total molecular weight 2. So, 10 divide 2, that's 5. Okay. So, ito yung ano. Ito yung combustion equation ko. Sir, bakit? Hindi ko maintindihan, sir. Bakit kinuha mo yung combustion equation? Because I want to get the gas constant of the, ano eh, of the combustion gases. Now that I have my mass balance, and then I have my combustion equation. I can actually dito ko na lang ilagay ha. Okay lang ba? Okay. Medyo kulang na tayo sa board eh. Okay. To get the gas constant, okay? Ano ba yung unit ng gas constant, 'di ba? Ano 'yan? Pound ng mass of yes, molecular pound per pound mole, okay? Okay, now I have the molecular weight total sa product, okay? I have the weight total of the product and I have the total moles in the product. So, I can actually get the, and I'm sorry, not the R. I don't want the R, hindi R. Hindi yung gas constant. The molecular weight, okay? I want the molecular weight first. And to get the molecular weight ng gas, okay? I have the total weight ng gas, ito lalabas, which is what? 90 plus 10. Tapos, yung pinaka-importante, alam ko na yung mole. Number of mole. Which is what? Ano? 5 and 5. Okay? So, yung molecular weight pala ng gas na palabas is you have the weights of the gases, 90 pounds ng water vapor, 10 pounds ng hydrogen gas divided by, okay, 5 moles ng water vapor plus, eto, 5 moles din, water vapor, tsaka 5 moles din ng hydrogen gas. 5, okay. So, we have what? 100 divided by 10. So, therefore, my molecular weight is equal to 10. Okay. Ito yung molecular weight ko. 10 pound per pound mole. Okay. Yun. Yan yung molecular weight ko. Okay, dito tayo. Molecular weight ko is, teka lang. Okay, next slide tayo. Yung molecular weight ko is 10. Nakuha ko na pound per pound mole. Or, pwede rin kilogram per k-mole. Pwede rin ganun. Okay, wala namang problema. Pwede namang ganyan, di ba? Per k-mole. Okay. Yung kagandahan kasi, pag alam ko na yung molecular weight, I can get the gas constant. Now, okay, yun. Gas constant. Which is what? 8. Alam natin to, 8.314 divided by the molecular weight, di ba? Ang unit nito, kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. Okay. So, now that we have, tawag dito, yung molecular weight, I can actually get my R. Okay? What is my R? 8.314 divided by 10. So, that's how much? Okay? That's 0 point, kahit hindi ka na mag-calculate, diba? That's 0.08314 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. Okay? Sige. So, anong next na gagawin natin, sir? Meron na tayong R, di ba? Balik tayo dito. Meron na tayong R, okay? So, I will need to get my T and P so that I can get my, di ba? I can get my velocity, my specific volume. Medyo madugo pala itong problem. Naman, siyempre, para practice mo itong mga gusto kong mga problem eh. So, I need to get the temperature and the pressure, ito, dito sa throat, okay? So, how do I get that? Well, daan muna tayo sa ano, class? Daan muna tayo sa formula ng stagnation temperature, okay? Hindi pwedeng, hindi, himayin natin to. Pwede naman ako mag-shortcut eh, pero gusto ko talagang i-explain eh. Well, stagnation temperature is equal, ano bang formula, di ba? The initial stagnation temperature is the temperature at any point in the nozzle plus the dynamic temperature, okay? Or equal to V squared over, alam nito, lahat ng nag-aaral ng, tawag dito, gas dynamics, high speed gas flow, okay? Alam natin na this is what you call the dynamic temperature, tama? Okay, and then if you add it to the temperature at any point in the nozzle, you get the stagnation temperature. Now, if I divide both sides or both sides by the temperature, ito, the temperature at any point, okay, we get what? TO over T equals what? And syempre, ito, madidivide to sa T, it will become 1. Dito, it will become V squared over 2CP times T. Okay, now, before we go on, ito lang, to move forward pala, ito lang yung i-focus natin muna. Ito lang. Yan lang. Kasi ito, okay na to eh. Mga simple lang yan eh. Ito lang muna. Okay, now, can you recall that Cp from thermodynamics is equal to what? Diba? Rk over k minus 1. Now, if we have that, we can actually substitute it to this expression here. Okay, so we can have what? V squared over 2 times Rk over k minus 1. Okay? And times T, syempre, that's Cpt. Now, I will rearrange this one, okay? And it will become, okay, lagyan ko na lang ng ano, divider class para hindi kayo maka-confuse. Okay? I will rearrange this. I will have it as V squared, okay, times, itong k minus 1, taas ko na, kasi denominator yan eh, k minus 1 times 2 k r t. Tama ba? Pwedeng ganun? Pwedeng ganun ba? Okay, sige, pwedeng ganun. Now, does this ring a bell to you, k r t? Sige. So, gas dynamics kasi, k r t is to get the speed of light, di ba? In the gas. Actually, the formula for that is what? C is equal to square root of KRT. Tama? Yes, correct. Now, I can have it as C squared equals to KRT. So, therefore, ito palang KRT ko, I can have it as C squared or in terms of the speed of light. So, I can rewrite this as what? V squared times K minus 1 divided by 2C squared. So therefore, I can have it as like this. Now, I can rewrite it further to be what? V squared. Sorry. Tama. V squared over C squared times k minus 1 over 2. Now, tingnan mo. Etong V over C actually, that is what you call the Mach number. Okay? The Mach number is equal to the velocity of any gas or any object, or for this matter, gas, divided by the speed of light, di ba? V over C. So, therefore, I am looking at now as, yung equation ko, I can rewrite it as k minus 1 over 2 times what? M squared. Okay. So, napakaganda. Napakaganda class. Now, if I have the expression, original expression of this into this, then I can rewrite my whole equation as what? Okay, TO over T equals 1 plus, ano nga yun? Huh? Ito, equals 1 plus, ito, yan, as this. So, I will have what? K minus 1 over 2 times M squared. This is really important with gas dynamics actually. Itong formula na to napaka-importante dito sa gas dynamics. Now, because this is what you use to get the temperature at any point. Okay? At any point in the nozzle. Especially sa throat. Kasi alam natin sa gas dynamics din, at the throat, it's sonic velocity. Sonic velocity. Pag gas flow dynamics, sa throat talaga sonic velocity yan. So, it means, pag sonic, the Mach number is equal to 1. Since in the problem, we want the temperature and the pressure at the throat, so therefore, it's sonic speed. The gas flow there is sonic. So, ibig sabihin, yung Mach number niyan is equal to 1 dyan. So, we will be left with what? TO over T equals to 1, okay, plus K minus 1 divided by 2, 1 squared, and parang ganyan lang. And then, yung 1, I can rewrite this at, kasi 1 squared yung M equals 1, so 1 squared 1, parang okay lang ganyan. Ganito na lang pagka-rewrite instead of having 1 there. Diba? So, I will have 1. Itong 1, I can rewrite it actually as 2 over 2 para mas makita nyo. Diba? 1 pa rin yan. Plus, para mas masimplify natin, K minus 1 over 2. So, if I simplify this, I will be left with what? TO over T equals what? Yes, correct. I will have K plus 1 divided by 2. Or, yung famous formula for critical temperature and critical pressures, I have T, baliktarin ko lang, over TO equals to 2 over K plus 1. Okay, so ito yung famous na formula sa gas dynamics. Okay, if you want the temperature at the nozzle, maybe let's call that para special, the temp, T asterisk. Wag na kasi marami na nga. Oh, temperature ng nozzle na TN. Ganon. Okay. The temperature of the nozzle is equal over the temperature of stagnation is equal to 2 over K plus 1. And by that, actually, makukuha na natin yung temperature sa nozzle. Because the temperature of the nozzle pala is just equal to stagnation temperature times what? Okay? 2 over K plus 1. Okay? In this scenario, ano ba yung TO natin? Sige nga. Balikan natin. The temperature is ito. See it? Diba? 2,704.44 degrees Celsius. So, balik tayo dito. 2,704.44 degrees Celsius. Oh, syempre, gawin ko yung Kelvin. Alam nga naman, diba? Plus 273. Okay, times 2 over... Ano bang K natin? Ah, anong K natin? K plus 1, that's 1.25. Diba? Ito yung problem. Ito yung K ng problem, 1.25. Tingnan nga natin. K ng problem. Yes! Correct. Yan. 1.25. Okay. Now, that's 1.25 plus 1. Okay. So, what is your nozzle temperature? Okay. Your nozzle temperature is equal to 2,704.44 plus 273, okay, times 2 over 1.25 plus 1, I have 2,646.61, okay, 2,646.61, okay, degrees, hindi, degrees kasi naka-Kelvin na pala yan, ito, Kelvin na ito eh, plus 273 ka na dyan, so that is Kelvin. Walang degree yung Kelvin, ha? Okay, Kelvin lang. 2,646.61 Kelvin. Okay, now, meron ka ng temperature ng nozzle. Kulang mo na lang yung pressure ng nozzle. Makukuha mo na yung ano? Makukuha mo na yung, tawag dito, yung pressure tsaka temperature. So, how can you do that? Well, pwede kang dumaan sa ano. Okay, daan ka dito. Okay? Next slide na pala kasi puno na eh. Okay, dito, dadaan ka sa, kasi pag nozzle, isentropic yung flow eh. S equals C. Automatic yan. Pwedeng tayo mag, actually, yung keyword dito, bakit pwede tayo mag-assume ng isentropic yung flow? Sinabi, disregard, dissociation, tsaka friction. So, it means, kung walang friction, automatic, isentropic yung flow sa nozzle mo. So, kung isentropic yung flow sa nozzle mo, pwede tayo mag-apply ng formula ng alam natin sa thermodynamics ng isentropic flow. Okay? Ano nga yun? T2 over T1, di ba? Alam natin yan, di ba? P2 over P1 raised to K minus 1 over K. Di ba? Isentropic formula. So, to get the temperature dun sa throat, we can use this one. So, I have what? Maybe I will start with throat temperature, di ba? Throat temperature, bakit nozzle yung bin, dapat throat sana eh, di ba? Hindi, okay, nozzle na lang, okay. Nozzle temperature divided by, sorry ha, kasi ngayon ko lang, I am solving it now. Well, hindi ko to sinolve, pre-solve, wala, hindi ko to sinolve ng una. I'm solving it as it is now. O kaya marami tayong mga ano, yung mga adlib, okay? Okay, na then divided by the stagnation temperature equals, okay, the pressure of the nozzle or the throat divided by the pressure, the ano tawag dito, pressure sa nozzle, pressure, stagnation pressure, and then K minus 1 over K. Okay, so what is the temperature ng nozzle nga? Okay, tingnan natin. 2,646.61 Kelvin. Okay, so 2,646.61 Kelvin divided by, ano yung temperature natin ng stagnation? Okay, that's, ito. 27, ito. Plus 273. 2,704.44 plus 273. That is how much? 2,704.44 plus 273, that's 2,977.44. Okay, lagay na lang natin dyan. 2,977.44 Kelvin. Okay, Kelvin na yan ha, equals, okay, ano nga yung pressure natin? Okay, PN, that's what we want, pressure sa nozzle or throat. Ano nga yung stagnation pressure natin? Balikan natin. Okay, ito. 2026.25 kilopascal. Okay? Sige nga. 2026.25 kilopascal raised to K natin 1.25 eh. Minus 1 divided by 1.25. I am getting the pressure at the nozzle to be what? 2,646. Pa-calculate lang ako class ha, kasi hindi guys, hindi ko pa to na solve eh. Ngayon lang 2,977.44.88. Okay, then I get the, okay, 1.25 answer, then answer, okay, and then I multiply 2,026.25, I am getting 1,124.42. okay, 1,124.42 kilo pascal. Okay, so ito yung pressure sa throat mo. Now that I have the pressure sa throat, I have the temperature ng throat. Ito, yan. And then I have the R, I can get the specific volume. Tama ba? O nga sir, ano? R, Tn over Pn. And that's what? Ano nga yung R natin? Ha? Meron ba? R. Yun is, ito. Okay, that's 0.8314 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. Okay, tayo dito. That is 0.8314 3.314 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. Okay, I will then multiply it by what? Temperature, which is what? 2646.61 Kelvin. Okay, divided by okay, the pressure 1124.42 kilopascal. Okay, alam naman natin yung magiging answer niyan is what? Specific volume in cubic meter per kilogram. Okay, it's coming together, sir. Grabe, ang taas naman, napaka madugo naman ito, sir. Oh, syempre naman. 8.314 times 2646.61. 0.83142646.61. Okay, divided by 1124.42. Okay, so we have what? 1.957. Ganito na lang. 1.957. Yun, cubic meter per kilogram. Okay pa. Ano ko ulit? Baka hindi tama. Divide 1124.42. Okay, so 1.957. Okay, so we have already the specific volume. Meron na tayong mass flow rate na kanina. Ano na lang kulang natin? Sir, velocity na lang kulang natin. Okay, velocity sa throat. Okay, walang problema. Kasi sabi ko nga kanina, di ba? Okay, alam naman natin, okay, that yung Mach number dito, doon na lang tayo daan sa Mach number. Marami kasing pwedeng daanan to get the velocity. Pwede doon sa dynamic temperature, pwede din doon sa Mach number. Kasi alam natin, the Mach number is what? V over C. Tama ba? So, if I know the Mach number to be 1, then I know that the velocity of the throat is equal to the velocity of the throat is equal to what? The speed of light at the gas at the throat. Okay, now C is equal to KRT, tama ba? I have the R, I have the temperature ng gas sa throat. Okay, I have it as TN, and then I have K, and I just have to be careful kasi dapat yung R natin dito is nasa joules. Okay, joules per kilogram Kelvin. And yung R na nandito natin is kilojoules. So, I have to multiply it by 1,000. So, the velocity will become what? Ng throat. K, R, TN, times 1,000. Itong 1,000 is just to make sure that itong R ko maging joules per kilogram Kelvin. Okay, so that's actually what? K, 1.25. R ko, tingnan mo, di ba yung R ko, that is 0.8. 314. Yung unit niyan, kilojoules kasi. Kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. Okay. Times TN, which is, ano yung TN natin? 2646. Okay. 0.61 Kelvin. Okay. Makikita mo na ito yung 1,000. It's to 1,000 joules per kilojoules. Tama ba? Just to convert kilojoules into joules. Kasi hindi ko gusto itong maging kilojoules. Otherwise, marong ako. So, ano yung velocity ko ngayon? Okay? That's 0.8314 times 1,000 times 2646 0.61 times 1.25. Okay? The square root of that. I have 1658.46. So, my velocity is 1658.46 meter per second. Okay? Lahat nandito na. I can solve already my area. Okay? Balik tayo dito. Ano nga yung kailangan nating formula to get the area? Ito, ito, ito. Yan. So, that's area is equal to mass flow rate, which I already have. Ito. Times the specific volume, which I already have. Nandun. And then, the velocity at the throat. Okay. So, balik tayo dito. Area is equal to ngayon. Mass flow rate times the specific volume divided by the velocity. So, nung ngayong mass flow rate natin, 45.0 45.35 kilogram per second. Okay, times ng specific volume, that's 1.957 okay cubic meter per kilogram. Okay, divided by the velocity 1658.46 meter per second. Okay, so what is my area now? Okay. Oop, hindi pa. Bakit nag... tayo eh. Yun tayo eh. Okay. So, kasi nag-look ko kanina, hindi tuloy nakita paano ko i-solve tong area. Pero actually, pag yan eh, inano mo na, in-substitute, pag sinubstitute mo na to, okay, yung mass flow rate ito, ito yung specific volume, ito yung velocity, you get the answer to be 0.05351 square meter. And if you want it to be in feet or square foot, okay, you can just multiply this by 3.281 squared, tama? And you get 0.576 square feet. Okay. Napakagandang problem class, ano? Kaya nga tinawag rocket science. Okay. I hope you enjoyed the video and see you in the next problem. Okay? Thank you so much for your attention.